The main news from this morning are three things. The first is that the Russians have received reinforcements in the Crimea. Secondly, that there have been multiple reports of Russian troops massing near the Ukrainian border near opposite Kharkiv. And lastly and most important, the Russians have surrounded and more or less have laid siege to at least 7 Ukrainian military bases throughout the Crimea. To put things into general perspective, all sides remain defiant. Despite all the tensions, the fuse being lit, it has yet to go off. Not a single shot has been fired. It's amazing, really. There was supposedly a mass resignation surrender of Ukrainian troops in the Crimea, but I have yet to see any proof of that. In fact, I'm seeing quite the opposite. Ukraine called up the reserves several hours ago. I really haven't seen too much about it, though, surprisingly. So right now as it stands, things have somehow become even more tense than yesterday. Armed standoffs saturate the Crimean landscape, but no shots have been fired at this time. Continue to stay tuned as I follow these intense developments in the Ukraine. More at the latest, Russian invaders captured the Ukrainian army base in Fyaland, disarming all soldiers. Hundreds of unidentified gunmen arrive outside Ukraine's infantry base in Privani in Crimea. There are at least 6 Ukrainian army bases besieged by Russian forces on Crimea now. In Belbek, Sevastopol, Balaklava, Kerch, Feodosia and Privom. The Ukrainian army base in Privom, 25 kilometers south of Simferopol, was surrounded by hundreds of invasion forces this morning, but the commander Colonel Igor Mamchur vows to defend it. Ukrainian army commander of the 36th Brigade of the Armed Forces in Simferopol says, his soldiers will stand to death versus Russian invaders. Russian forces surrounding the 39th training group of the Ukrainian Navy in Sevastopol. See video. The Ukrainian MOD reports, its ATC confirms the arrival of 11 more Russian combat helicopters and 7 Il-76 in Crimea. Breaking news. Must be the third or fourth report in the last 24 hours. Russian troops mass on the Russian side of the border near Kharkiv. These are reported to be the 2nd Guards Red Banner Army, 23rd Separate Guards Motorized Rifle Brigade and 15th Separate Motorized Rifle Brigade. Ukrainian armed forces dispatched to Crimea have started resigning on a massive scale, reports RIA Novosti. Living quarters, weapons and ammunition have all been left under the protection of the so-called self-defense forces. Letters of resignation have been coming in since early morning, as the self-defense forces continue to preserve order on the streets of Simferopol, RIA reported. Source BBC TV reporting that Russian troops are digging trenches at the land border between Crimea and rest of Ukraine. Belarus army on alert as NATO troops move towards Ukraine. Reports Crimea source unconfirmed. The United States missiles shield and Poland on alert as Belarus moves army on border. Crimea source Russia's three news agencies RIA, Interfax and TAT'S now unanimously report mass resignations of Ukrainian men in Crimea. Interfax, UK Air Naval Infantry BN Feodosia reports it's blockaded by armed troops, who order them to surrender by 1000L or face attack. Russian forces try to seize anti-aircraft missile base in Ukraine's Crimea. Interfax, Russian military servicemen have taken weapons from a radar base and naval training facility in Ukraine's Crimea region, and urge personnel to side with the peninsula's legitimate leaders, Interfax news agency said on Sunday. It quoted a Ukrainian Defense Ministry source as saying the Russian servicemen had taken pistols, rifles and ammunition cartridges from the radar post near in the town of Sudak and taken them away by car. Another group of Russian military had also removed weapons from a Ukrainian Navy training center in the port city of Sevastopol, where Russia's Black Sea Fleet also has a base source. The Common Sense Show. Can't you feel it? Something big is coming in the Ukraine, which is going to impact everyone across the planet. However, most of you will sit on your hands until it is too late, as you have deluded yourself into thinking that because the conflict is halfway around the world, that you are safe. Nothing could be further from the truth, and if you knew your history, you would already have begun to prepare for what is coming. Americans of the World War II era do not need to learn this lesson of history. If Russia invades Ukraine and the United States becomes militarily involved, Your access to vital and basic resources could be called into question. Anyone born into the baby boom generation and younger has no idea what you could be facing. We are not fighting the Viet Cong or Iraq, we could be fighting a superpower who has a significant reach deep inside of this country. My advice to you, America, is to make a significant shopping run after you are done reading this article. Putin has won the first battle of WWIII. It is now clear that the Russians are in complete control of the strategic infrastructure in Crimea. The Russians control the major roads, the government buildings, the airports, the key utilities, and now there are reports surfacing that they are moving to control the distribution of food within Crimea. In short, Crimea is under Russian martial law. The Ukraine prepares for war with Russia. Nathan Frandino, Ukraine's national security chief, accuses Russia of being behind the seizure of Crimea's airports and warns against direct aggression. The following video speaks to the fact that Ukraine has drawn a line in the sand. Unlike Obama, the paper tiger, the Ukraine is prepared to meet the Russian incursion into Crimea with steadfast Ukrainian aggression. The following short video is an Ukrainian declaration of war against further Russian aggression against the sovereignty of the Ukraine within the Republic of Crimea. There is no interpretation needed for the following Ukrainian declaration of war. Can Ukraine survive the coming Russian invasion? For over a week, the Russian military has had a 150,000-man contingent on military maneuvers within mere miles from the Ukrainian border. Historically, military maneuvers are a precursor for a war that has gone live. Ukraine's Security Council has ordered the army to immediately put all military forces on war alert. However, Kiev's small and poorly equipped military is no match for Russia's incursion force into Crimea. My military sources tell me that the 150,000 Russian military force operating just off their border with Ukraine could secure the country in less than 3 days, unless the Russians encountered a decisive intervention from NATO. If the newly established pro-Western government of Ukraine is to survive, they will require military assistance from the West, primarily NATO and the forces of the United States in the very near future. The Russians reportedly have 7 to 10 days to close the door on any meaningful NATO intervention. In other words, if Putin is going to invade the Ukraine, it will be this week. Without Western support, Ukraine could be facing genocide if the Russians move to subdue Ukraine this week, before the West can respond militarily, deposed and pro-Russian Prime Minister Yanukovych could return to power. And given the brutality that Yanukovych displayed towards Ukrainians, a genocidal crackdown with Russian military support likely awaits the local citizens, particularly in Kiev, where the protests were especially vehement. If the government of Ukraine were smart, they would begin to arm each and every citizen and begin to immediately coach them on how to carry out guerrilla warfare, because the Ukrainian military could cease to exist in the next 7 to 10 days. Options for the United States Navy 6th Fleet. As the United States Navy 6th Fleet moves towards Crimea, the Russian strategy of seizing the coastal ports and airports in Crimea now makes perfect sense. Without access to the ports and airports, American Marines would find it difficult, if not impossible, to enter Crimea. There can be no question that the Russian Black Sea Fleet has deployed its submarines to a level where they will prevent the American Navy from approaching Crimea and enacting a military intervention in support of the Ukrainian troops now trapped in Crimea. Meanwhile, if Putin acts now and invades Ukraine, it would make perfect sense. Possession, as they say, is 90% of the law. Clearly, NATO is not prepared to act in time to save Ukraine. If Russia is to attack to keep Ukraine from joining the European Union, the time is now. Conclusion: there is no conclusion, because these events are about to become very fluid. The only accurate conclusion that can be put upon this volatile situation is that if the Russians act now and they invade Ukraine, and the West does find a way to militarily respond, then Putin will have moved a long way in securing his long-range goal of constructing an Eurasian empire capable of challenging the United States anywhere in the world. Now I turn my attention to the title of this article, Americans Be Warned, Stock Up on Supplies Now Before It's Too Late. If the United States responds militarily, and the Russians retaliate, your ability to get food, heat your home, go to work and whole host of other factors will be called into question, because the Russians will respond within the borders of the United States.